It's the NFL on EA Sports. And if it's in the game, it's in the game. It's the Philadelphia Eagles and the Minnesota Vikings. Coming up next.
A very warm day outside by Minnesota standards, but then again, it is still summer. Either way, the AC is working just fine at U.S. Bank Stadium in the Twin Cities. Today, we've got a good NFC matchup on tap between the Philadelphia Eagles and the Minnesota Vikings. And a welcome in, everybody, with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gauden, and Charles, so much gets made about offensive comparisons. Here's a matchup where the defenses may just take center stage.
Yeah, we're usually talking about guys scoring touchdowns. How about the guys who prevent them and change the momentum of the game when they take the ball away? I love those ball hawks in the secondary. People after my own heart.
Greg Joseph now ready to get this one started, and we are underway from Minneapolis. This taken in at the goal line. And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. Now for the first time, we get to see this Philadelphia offense led out by their dual-threat quarterback now in his third season, Jalen Hurts.
Jalen Hurts got the green light as a starter from the Philly organization and took really good steps as the next in line of mobile quarterbacks in the city, following names like Michael Vick, Donovan McNabb, and Randall Cunningham. He led the team in all quarterbacks in the NFL in rushing, and he took Philadelphia to the postseason while throwing for over 3,000 yards.
They'll throw on first down with Hurts. It's caught by Sanders. And he's going to be taken down. Plus, there's a penalty flag in the backfield. They may get 15 more on top of this. Well, they were setting up the screen, CD, a lot of free runners, and they got there late, and the penalty ensued.
Yeah, somehow it didn't get into their brains that it was a screen, right? Instead of pulling off and chasing the ball downfield, they kept going towards the quarterback and knocked him down way late. That draws the penalty flag each and every time.
Hurts a handoff to Sanders.
And after that type of a run, there's some talking going on down on the field, but it's not trash talking. The guy who just carried the ball, he's going back and telling his offensive line, great job, keep it up, and we'll break that one soon.
So not quite a first down just yet as they come up on second and less than a yard. They run with Sanders off the option. And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
That's a very nice game there. A confidence-building run. Love the execution up front. And the way he pressed the hole, absolutely perfect.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Another run with Sanders. And he'll take it down to the 30-yard line. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave them with a second and 2.
If these kinds of lanes are available, you have to feel like he's going to have a pretty big game on the ground.
Yeah, you can tell early on he's got a little burst in his step, and that's a big pickup right there on first down.
8 yards the tally on that first down run. Here's second and two. Throwing is Hurts. And this is caught by Watkins. And he'll be brought down at the 27. On first and 10, it's Sanders. And he edges forward, but only gets a pair of yards out of it. And it's second down. Second and 8. From the gun, it's Hurts. It's caught on the right side at Smith. And they're going to get this down to about the 17-yard line here.
Devontae Smith's workload certainly didn't get any lighter going from being a Heisman Trophy winner at Alabama to his first year with the Philadelphia Eagles. 104 targets as a rookie and his 916 yards, they were the most for a Philly wideout since 2015. They go to him there for a first down.
So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. Forced out to his left. And they're going to get this down inside the 15.
Ask any pass rusher and they'll tell you, any quarterback who lines up every time and goes straight back in the pocket, that's who they want. But when they have to deal with a Jalen Hurts who may come at them from any angle and can get outside of the pocket and run, that's a nightmare for anybody who has to rush the quarterback. And I love Jalen Hurts' athletic ability. Almost a 4-6 runner, this guy can get outside the pocket and make plays with his legs as well as his arm.
And the Eagles are going to have a first and goal as the tackle is made at about the 5. First and goal, a chance for an early statement here on the road. On the ground with a tight end. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the 4. They'll get 2 out of that run, and it's going to bring up a second and goal.
A lot can go wrong when you call a play like this down in the red zone, but that's where you appreciate this from your head coach. He's not afraid to trust his guys to do the right thing. And as a player, that means an awful lot.
Sanders is into the end zone for an Eagle touchdown. Well, first quarter, maybe too early to talk about statement drives, Charles, but that sure seemed like a statement drive right there.
Well, if we're going to talk about statement drives, I think what they're saying is we're going to establish the run. They gave it to him early and often on this drive, and he wound up taking it into the end zone.
On for the extra point, Jake Elliott. He's got it, and the Eagles lead it 7-0. A 10-play drive that time, and it was Miles Sanders who finished it off with a touchdown run. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. fielded just outside the goal line. And taken down just past the 20 at about the 21-yard line. The Vikings offense coming out for the first time, and in his fifth season leading this crew, coming off his third career Pro Bowl nod, Kirk Cousins.
Kirk Cousins is back for his fifth year as Minnesota starter, tied for the longest streak of stability the team has had at quarterback since, get this, Fran Tarkenton in the late 1970s. He's been excellent during that time, making a second Pro Bowl last season after 4,200 yards and 33 touchdowns through the air. The Vikings, though, still hovering right around 500 at the 8-win mark, hoping to see him lead a talented roster back to the postseason.
Cousins and the Vikings with a first and 10 at their own 21. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Eagle pressure, too much this time. Down he goes. Multiple players combined for their team's first sack of the game. And they get to him right out of the gate. And this defense hoping that that's a harbinger of things to come.
Yeah, when you give up a first play sack, makes your quarterback wonder if he's going to go to the sidelines and talk with his offense coordinator and head coach and say, hey, you know that game plan we put together? We might need to change it right now.
So after the sack here, second and 14. The first carry now for Dalvin Cook. And he'll get this past the 20 as he gets about four. On third down, Cousins. Oh, going for Jefferson downfield. And that's caught inside the 30. And they're going to move it down inside the 25. Well, he's been doing this for a lot of years with the arm strength still there, and he showed it off on that one.
And look, you're down 7-0 in the first quarter. You know it's not a time to panic or feel like you've got to get those points back right away. But how about their conviction and taking that chance to throw the ball deep right there, knowing they can hit on plays like this? I'll bet that won't be the last time we see him take a deep shot in this game.
And that throw, pretty impressive, and even 61 yards through the air. First down, here's the run with Cook. And not much, maybe a yard down to the 23.
And that's the type of play that'll fire up the defense, hold them to 1 yard on a first down run. It'll be interesting to see if the offense decides to press the run at all or if they'll abandon it now after gaining only one on that play.
After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Second quarter now from Minnesota. It's the Vikings in possession of the football as they're looking at a second down and 9 to go. A throw there, but that's going to wind up incomplete. So the pass goes out of bounds, but he was not outside of the tackle box when he threw that. He's got to be careful.
You and I both know if it's even close, they're going to give it to the quarterback. They don't want to throw that flag unnecessarily. So if you're just in the area, you're going to be okay.
From the gun, here's Cousins. Got an open man finding Jefferson. And he will have a Vikings first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
Now a first and 10 at the 11. Throwing his Cousins. His pass caught at the 4. That was play number 7 on this drive, and it got him 7 yards. Let's second down, ball on the three. First down marker at the 1 yard line. They'll try the wide side with Cook. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. That's going to go down as a loss of five, and it brings up third down. Another example right there how this defense really is winning the entire game at the point of attack.
Yeah, right there at the line of scrimmage because they are dominating it. It allows their interior guys to get upfield and spill into the backfield. So how are you going to combat that? You know, because they bring in your tight end, keep him in, your running backs, they have to step forward. Bottom line, your offensive line has to block them first to give yourself a chance.
Here's Cousins. And he's got it. Touchdown, Vikings. K.J. Osborne from 8 yards out. And the Vikings are an extra point away from drawing level.
And that drive we just saw that culminated in a touchdown, exactly what many offenses are looking for. Sustained ones that can impose their will on the other team.
Greg Joseph on for the extra point. It's up and good, and we're tied at seven here in quarter number two. A good drive that time as they go nine plays in all, and it's polished off by a Viking score. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. Fielded just outside the goal line. And able to get this across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped at the 23-yard line. So back onto the field here come the Eagles for their second drive. A lot of time for this unit to game plan on the sideline after that drive that they watched the other side just score. But remember, last time they were out, they scored as well. We'll see if they can seize that momentum right back.
And they have had a lot of time to cool off from reaching the end zone the last time. So have they been able to keep themselves mentally sharp and into this game, even though they haven't been on the field? And you and I both know, one big play, though, gets them right back up to that level.
Hurts throw there, taken in by Smith. And he'll get this one way up just shy of the 45-yard line. A good pickup there, 21 yards. Took just one play to move all the way to the 44 as they try again on first down. Shotgun snap and then the give to Sanders. Boy, shifts past him. And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40. 15 more yards there and quickly another first down. So they go pass, now they go run, and two plays resulting in really nice pickups.
Certainly sounds like a 50-50 deal, doesn't it? Sounds like great balance. Well, you know what all those coaches have told us over the years, Brandon, that balance is? It means doing what you want to when you want to. That play calling is working very well for them right now.
From Viking territory now, they'll come up first and 10 at the 41. Hurts sets up to throw it. Escaping the pressure right. And he'll take this beyond the line of scrimmage as he slides to a hole. They'll wind up getting right about four there on the scramble, and it's second down.
They made a nice effort to stick him with a loss for that play, but it's going to take more than that to keep him from advancing the ball. Should be an entertaining battle anytime he tucks and runs over the second half of this contest.
To throw again on second down. Hurts complete. Smith has it. And he's going to be taken down at the 28-yard line.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving. Give us a
On first and 10, it's Hurts. He finds his man complete. It's Watkins. And he's brought down here just outside of the 20. That time they hit him out of the slot on the drag.
And that route takes some fortitude from the guy running it because he knows he's going through the briar patch, as I like to call it, right? He's trying to work his way through all that traffic and people wanting to put a little contact on it. Really well done.
They'll fake the give to Sanders, and now Hurts. Hurts fumbles it.
Much like a running back going through the line, quarterbacks have to be aware of protecting the football as well. He left it exposed that time, wound up having it knocked free, but fortunately, had an alert teammate who was able to get it.
So possession still theirs, but now they face a third down. Here's Hurts to throw. And he'll protect himself at the end here as he winds up getting pretty decent yardage. Give him 8 yards that time on the scramble, and now fourth down.
I thought he did a pretty good job there to get back what he could, but let's face it, that sack on second down, talk about throwing a wrench into the works. He certainly did.
Yeah, he did everything he could there, trying to pick up some positive yardage, and he did, but not enough.
We've hit the two-minute mark of the first half. All knotted up, it's 7. They're going on fourth down with Hurts.
And it's incomplete. They cannot convert. And they turn it over. The Eagles unable to convert there on fourth. And the Vikings defense is going to get the football back. So the defense has to stay out and get one more stop. They were able to do it, forcing the incompletion.
So on their record, that goes down as a successful play. Doesn't matter how they got there, how it happened. They got it done. They're the ones that are jubilant.
Cousins on first down. That one into the hands of Thielen, complete. And he'll go down at the 26, following a gain of 6. From the 26, they'll line up on 2nd and 4. They go play action. Cousins. Adam Thielen back. The ball comes out. And this is going to get out of bounds. So they will gain a bit of yardage on the play, actually. And they'll hold on to the football as well.
Well, obviously, you never want to fumble. But if you do, good to be towards the sideline and saves them the possession.
Saves the embarrassment. Saves it going down on the play sheet as a turnover. But I still think it should go to the defense, even if they don't recover it. If you give up the football, you gave up the football.
Agree to disagree, I guess.
Can you tell what I played?
Yeah, you played defense. Yeah. I'll let you go.
I took a shot.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on 1st and 10. To throw is Cousins. Over the middle, and it's incomplete. Tight end Irv Smith, the intended receiver.
And it's 2nd down. That pass just a little bit off. It looked like maybe he tried to force it in there.
Game speed, always different, no matter what you do in practice. Can't simulate it, right? So your decision making, everything has to be a little bit quicker. Sometimes it can throw you off until you adjust.
On 2nd down, Cousins again. That's to Dalvin Cook, his running back.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. The Vikings going to signal for their first of their timeouts, as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. So two first downs, and that moves the ball to the 42 now, first and 10. Now Cousins. Smith catches left side. Now another timeout called for by the offense as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half.
I got you, baby. Let's go do this thing, baby.
Let's go.
Cousins again. And Cook has it, left side. And they're able to work this across midfield to the 48. First down now, but the clock continues to move. Cousins. And that is, I think he caught it. He did, but they'll say out of bounds. It'll be incomplete. That hold coming from the left side of the line.
Hands got caught in the cookie jar on that one, and the flag came out. Penalty against them.
Throwing, Cousins. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Darius Slay with a pick.
Well, Charles, you know, so close to halftime there, you throw the interception. Not only that, you do give it to them in plus territory as well.
Yeah, they were pushing real hard to try and get something more on the board on their side of the ledger right before the half. Looking at it with 20-20 hindsight, though, might have been better to hand it off a few times, hoping to get something to break instead of putting the ball in the air and, of course, putting the ball in jeopardy.
Well, the Eagles going to get one final possession in this first half.
And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Final 17 seconds of the half here as they come up to the line, first and 10.
Hurts.
Left side here to Sanders. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. From the 38, Hurts. And he works his way past the line of scrimmage and then slides to a halt. And now we'll get a late timeout as it comes in the waning moments of quarter number two. They'll throw now on the final play. And that is incomplete. So a touchdown apiece. That's what we have to show at halftime as they head to the locker room. 7-7 our score. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. Welcome everyone to our brand new studios here in downtown Orlando in the EA Sports Halftime Report. First things first, let's get a check on the next-gen stats from that first half for Philadelphia. And you can see their quarterback had his moments running the football. With his speed, that might be something to try to lean on a little bit more in the third and fourth quarters to come.
All right, Coach, thanks. Yeah, both teams likely to make some changes in what's been a closely fought battle to this point.
Set and ready to go for the second half. One touchdown apiece, 7-7 our score.
And no fireworks to start the half. This will be a touchback.
Out come the Vikings. They'll have it first on offense as we begin the third.
Well, the first half, very even. I mean, really, in all facets, this ball game tied, Charles. So as we start the third quarter, curious to see what the second half brings us.
Certainly am. I'm with you on that one. And we all know a lot of coaches from the NFL all the way down to the peewee level. They love to spin it to their teams. Hey, we're starting a brand new shorter ball game. It's all even. Let's go out and seize it. This is ours.
Starting the third quarter with Cook. And he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up.
But they certainly got dented with that first down run. So now they've got to be back on their heels a little bit as a defense.
Second and six, just inside the 30. Play action now, Cousins. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Cook. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. That one, a first down pickup of eight. Cousins gives way to Cook. And this will be stopped at the 44. That one good for 7 yards.
Good yardage there on first down. Exactly what you want. Get yourself set up to keep making first downs. Keep the clock running. And if they're smart, you're starting to milk the clock. No hurry before you run your second down play.
On second down, it's Cook again.
And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
They were not fooling around at all, were they? Second and short, and they brought out the heavy package. Almost felt like the super heavy package against that defense, didn't it?
Yeah, I don't think they expected that much beef up front, and it turned into an easy first down conversion. Cousins now to throw on first down. Throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete.
I think he's a little trigger happy right there, and it turned into an ill-advised throw into their zone.
Well, we know he has confidence. He'll throw it any place, anytime, anywhere. That time it fell incomplete. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Working out of the gun, Cousins.
Middle of the field to Jefferson.
And they get to him after a gain of six to the 46. Here's the seventh play of this drive. This is third and four. Now Cousins. And he's got his tight end, that's Smith. And he will have a Vikings first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Well, a lot of times when you get a manageable third down situation like this, you have to think about your tight end, and he comes through for him, picking up the first down.
Yeah. Up the middle, it's Cook. Down right around the 25. It was Josh Sweat who got him down on the defensive side.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
On second and nine, Cousins toward the sideline. And look at that catch, dragging the toes. And that's going to be a first down. Well done. They give him 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs.
Nice job there of utilizing his big target. He didn't overthink it. Understands the catch radius, understands that he knows how to use his body to keep defenders away from the ball, and puts it right out there for the nice pickup.
From down at the 12, it's first and 10. They'll try the middle with Cook. Down to the 6-yard line on a pickup of 6 as he gets halfway to the goal line.
And when you get good yardage like that on first down, it really does a whole lot of good for your entire offense. But I love the way he's finishing those runs. At the end of things, he's making sure he gets just a little bit extra.
Second and 4. They could still get a first down without scoring. Here's Cook again. And he will fight his way into the end zone for a touchdown. Dalvin Cook, a 6-yard touchdown run. And the Vikings have taken the lead as they go right down the field and score on the opening drive of the second half. Hard to argue with that being their best drive of the game so far as they used the running game to get them into the end zone.
Couldn't agree more, partner. Prior to that drive, they sputtered a little bit, but it looks like they found the formula. I would expect them to go back to that more and more as this game develops.
Joseph on for the extra point. And he's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game. A pretty long drive that time. 11 plays all told. And it's capped off by the touchdown run coming from Dalvin Cook. Now Joseph tees it up to kick off following the touchdown. Taken at the goal line. Now a hit and a loose football. And the Vikings pick up the football. And his guys will take over at the 25-yard line. And careless with a football there on the kick return.
And one thing I love about going to practices is trying to get around coaches and hear their catchphrases and what they really emphasize. We haven't been to a single one yet this year where a guy fielding a kick, you don't hear, tuck it away, tuck it away, tuck it away. And this time, they turned it over.
Ball security eluded him. A first down throw for Cousins. Flush to his right. And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down.
As soon as he leaked out and began his route, someone on the defensive side broke with him and arrived just in time to separate him from another reception.
Glad to have you with us from Minneapolis. Third quarter here, second and 10. To throw, Cousins. Complete, Jefferson the target. And down inside the 15 he goes. Cousins in step with Jefferson that time. First down Vikings. drop to throw. He'll find Thielen working the middle. And the Vikings are going to have a first and goal coming up as the tackle made at the 3-yard line. Play action, Cousins. And he is going to go down back at the 11-yard line. That's sack courtesy of the effort of Hassan Reddick.
That I'm struggling to understand a little bit. That close to the goal line, first down, run the football. If you want to throw it, throw some play action on second down.
So they get pushed back to the 11, and here's second and goal. Another try after the first down sack. Cousins. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away. They've been so good on third down all day long. Can they convert another here on third and goal? Cousins to throw it. And he comes back with one complete. A gain of 5, but not enough. Leads to a fourth and goal.
Brandon, a good idea there on third down. Run a little clear out and hope you can get your receiver the ball coming across the formation. Nice design, but well played defensively, and they stop him well short.
Fourth down, field goal try coming, so Cousins is off, and on comes Greg Joseph for Minnesota.
Joseph's got it, and they will move up by 10 now, 17-7.
So the lead grows here incrementally, but I think the way their defense is playing, you feel okay with just getting 3.
They've definitely been stout so far, but now that could all change, because if one guy gets loose for 70 yards, this is a different game. But as it stands, field goals are good. Just keep adding to that lead.
Joseph now to kick this one away. And not willing to risk another fumble, he'll sit on this one. It's a touchback. Try to get one more in here before the quarter breaks. They start on the ground here at Sanders. It'll be a pickup of 4, and it winds us down to the end of the third quarter. We have played 3 quarters. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. And we return welcoming you back to Minneapolis. It's the Eagles behind on the scoreboard, but with the football here as we start the fourth quarter. Over the middle, he's got Watkins. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39.
Well, following the play now, they're going to stop the clock here as a man is shaken up. Well, hopefully, obviously, nothing serious here. Medical staff, though, going to take a peek, and we'll take a break.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Here comes Sanders on the toss right. And he is going to lose yardage here. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
Partner, one thing I was lousy at growing up, track and field, I could never anticipate the start before a race, but how about that backer? He figured it out, jumped the count, and turned it into a really nice play for his defense.
Looking at a second and 11 now after the loss. Throwing is Hurts. And on the catch right side, this is Sanders. Give him six on the screen, but now it's third down.
Partner, I like the play call coming right after a tackle for a loss because this is an obvious passing situation, but instead they fooled him a little bit with the screen and they wound up getting back what they lost and then a little bit more.
And the Vikings are going to beef up their secondary here. Six DBs on third.
Hurts sets up to throw it.
And that is incomplete.
Well, how about the coverage we just saw him break out on third down? Dime defense, blanketed the field with extra defensive backs and speed, unable to find an open hole to complete that pass.
They're going on fourth down with Hurts.
Over the middle to Smith. And able to pick up the first across midfield to the 47. The time to pull out the stops is now, and they convert there on fourth down. Both sides were holding their breath there on that fourth down play, and the offense can breathe a sigh of relief.
And both knew exactly where the first down markers were. You know the defense is trying to guard those sticks and try and keep people in front, but somehow, some way, those guys found a way to pick it up.
From Viking territory now, they'll come up first and 10 at the 47.
Here's Hurts to throw. A quick throw there, going to be batted away and incomplete.
The coverage keyed in on him since that last completion his way. He earned a little more attention on that route, and that made it a lot tougher to get a clean throw his way.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Partner, what we're seeing so far is the defense is certainly coordinated. Both levels doing their jobs in tandem. The back helping the front helping the back. The pressure got home on that last play and forced him to try and throw through contact and short of the sticks.
Again, he'll drop to throw. And this is going to turn into another first down as the tackle is made at the Vikings' 31-yard line. They give him 17 yards that time as that'll move the chains.
He certainly isn't looking at the scoreboard out there because, to me, all he's concerned about is analyzing the field and making most of the time left in this game. Deficit's still there, but he's starting to hit them with some big plays.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. He'll look to throw. Out to the left there and complete to the tight end, Goddard. And he'll be brought down at the 27.
Well, they're unable to convert that into much, but it's never a bad idea to try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can cause.
Now a second down and 6. They go play action with Hurts.
His throw incomplete.
Oh, they'll certainly be on the tablets going over that one for sure. Clearly, they were expecting something else out of the defense and couldn't adjust to make that completion happen.
The Eagles on third down. They've only converted once in 4 tries. This will be 3rd and 6. Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete.
Sometimes the game is pretty simple. Put a few extra defensive backs on the field, give them nowhere to throw the football, force the incompletion, and get off the field on third down.
So the field goal unit is on the field, as this is a big spot right here. This from 44 yards out, left hash. The kick by Elliott is good, and they're back within a touchdown. It's 17-10. All right, so they needed two scores to get back in the game. The field goal there, maybe not exactly what they wanted, but the necessary first step.
There's still time remaining, and there's enough time to get it done. They've got to get at the least a three and out here to get the ball back, preferably a takeaway.
After the field goal, here's Elliott to kick it away. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. And now this offense comes back out onto the field. They're holding on right now to that slim advantage in a one-score game. And you hear a lot about two-minute offense and four-minute offense. Obviously, the four-minute offense applies here. How do they run that effectively?
Yeah, really what the four-minute offense is you're just trying to grind the clock. So you want consistent gains, steady gains. Doesn't have to be big plays, but it has to be plays that gets first downs and keeps the ball away from your opponent.
But certainly throwing the ball is in the mix here.
It certainly is. Just make sure that you're careful with it. And again, get those first downs, keep possession of the football.
And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. Athleticism on display there by Derek Barnett to come up and get him. And the trend continues here in the fourth like it was in the first, second, and third. He's had nowhere to run.
And you're probably thinking to yourself, why do they keep feeding him the football? Well, they trust him first and foremost. They do believe that over time he might actually pop one of these runs. But the bottom line is, he takes care of the ball well for them, so they'll keep handing it to him.
On second and 12, Cousins. Throw left side, taken in by Jefferson. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. That catch puts him right at 100 yards receiving now, and it also gives him a first down. This is something you got to be wary of defensively. I mean, just because they're in the mode of trying to burn some clock doesn't mean they won't pass it, and they got good yardage out of that one.
Yeah, and really, when you're looking at it, now they've got a fresh set of downs. Look for second down. If they want to take another shot and try and loosen things up, that'd be the time to do it.
On the jet sweep, here comes Jefferson. And he'll take this up over the 40 to about the 41. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
Well, they gave up a few yards there, but all in all, I think it's a pretty nice job defensively against the jet sweep. If they don't slow him up, he might take it to the house. So they'll take that play every time on the defensive side of the ball.
From the 41, Cousins is going to float this one deep right side. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
One thing that offensive guys stress when they throw the deep ball, you're just counting on your receiver to find it, adjust before the defensive back can get his head around. In this case, though, the DB matched it move for move and knocked it away.
So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves him staring up here at a 3rd and 8. Cousins lets it fly for Thielen and unable to connect, incomplete. Give them credit, they took their shot, but it's going to bring up 4th down.
Sure, that pass was incomplete as they made an attempt to get a big one downfield, but that's okay because the second part of that is if you don't get the completion, at least you've told the defense you're trying to stretch them out a little bit and they may have to change accordingly.
Here's Jordan Berry now. And surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team. Calls for the fair catch, makes the fair catch just inside the 15-yard line. Hurts and the Eagles now, trailing 17-10, 2:15 remaining. Needing to go pretty much the length of the football field as they have it 1st and 10.
They'll throw on first down with Hurts.
This is complete to Watkins on the slant.
And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game.
So it's Eagle football here as we get you reset. They come up on a second down now, and a game that looks like it's going to go down the wire.
Into the hands of Sanders.
And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line.
That one, a first down pickup of 8.
To throw.
Finding Watkins. Gets around him.
And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44.
12 yards is the pickup. Good for an Eagle first down.
That's a nice job right there, partner, because they were able to work down the middle of the field, working in the seams, because I think defensively, they were guarding the sidelines, trying to keep them from getting out of bounds. They took what they gave them, and it was successful.
Hurts. Open man downfield is Sanders. He's got him.
And he'll cross over out of bounds right at the 25. It'll go as an impressive 31-yard gain.
A lot of running backs in the passing game, they're just used to check it down to them or maybe dump off passes. But this guy, they use him to stretch the field, don't they?
He stretched it right there, turned it into a really nice game.
The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10.
He'll look to throw. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Watkins. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and 2.
That completion helps out in a nice way. Now they can take a little bit more time, but guess what? They've got to make sure on their throws that they see it open, not just anticipate it.
And we've reached the 1 minute mark in this game. He's back to throw.
That swung out wide to Sanders.
And they work this near the 5. He'll be stopped at the 6. It's a good gain of 11. Sets him up first and goal.
I like the play design there. They occupied the defense downfield, everyone trying to account for someone. But unfortunately, they didn't account for the running back slipping out of the backfield, and he was absolutely unnoticed and wound up getting big yards on that play.
Back to throw. Flushed out right. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as the clock stops with 23 seconds to go in the game. So the ball position now at the 3. Here's second and goal.
They'll look to throw.
Man open left side is Brown. So back-to-back plays, each get nothing. And this brings up a 3rd and goal. Now another timeout called for by the offense. That'll leave them with just 1 remaining in this 4th quarter of play.
Third and goal. And keep in mind, very possibly 4-down territory. Hurts.
And this ball is caught. It's a touchdown. And now in the final seconds, they're a PAT away from likely getting this thing to overtime.
And that touchdown means a decision has to be made. Do they kick the PAT and tie it up, or do they go for 2 and try and win it right now?
So now this will be, in all likelihood, to force overtime. And we've got a timeout. 9 seconds remaining. So now this will be, in all likelihood, to force overtime. And he has got it. So barring something crazy on the kickoff, we're looking at an extra period to decide this one. So that drive consumes 9 plays all told.
And the touchdown capped off by the PAT, and that means that we are likely heading to overtime.
...17-17 the score, all even to this point as the kick's away.
Kenny Nwangu now out of his end zone. And he's only going to make it to the 13-yard line and no further.
They'll start on the ground here on first down.
Knifes his way forward here, but just 3 yards on the play. Second down.
And we need overtime to decide this one after 4 quarters of play. We're all even. The extra session in a moment. This is the NFL on EA Sports. It's a little teaching moment here. Overtime rules. Remind us how this goes, partner.
Okay, so in the past, we had sudden death. First team to score wins, but no longer. Now, if the team receives the ball, scores a touchdown, they win the game. If they kick a field goal, though, or don't score, the other team gets a possession. And after both teams get a possession, then we're into sudden death. First team to score wins the game.
So it's the Eagles who will get the first chance to go down and find a winner as they'll get it here, and we are back underway. Fielded just outside the goal line. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25.
The Eagles offense now, they head back on the field.
Well, they fought hard to reach this point, Charles, and now what an opportunity. They've got the ball first, a chance to take this overtime win away from the hostile crowd.
And you know, as the quarterback steps into the huddle, the first thing he's telling his team is, remember, we need 6, not 3. So we don't need a good drive. We need a great drive. And this is what they've been planning for. It's time to execute and take it downfield, even against all these odds.
It'll be Sanders to begin the drive. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, 2nd and 2.
Playing against a 3-4 front is really challenging for offensive linemen because they can do so many different things. But when you're running the football, if you can handle the nose tackle up front, and then maybe a guard can slide up to the second level and block a linebacker, that's when you have success running the football.
Another run here with Sanders. And he is going to lose yardage here. He'll lose a yard on the play, so now they need 3 yards on third down.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result, negative yardage. Now a first throw here in overtime. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. Big yardage there on the scramble. It gets him a first down.
Well, he and his offense were staring down what was likely a 3 and out.
Zero fear from his side, though. Never doubt for a second they pick up the first. He's ready to pull the trigger on a keeper the moment it revealed itself.
From Viking territory now, they'll come up first and 10 at the 44-yard line. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. Open man is Goddard, the tight end. And the tackle going to be made at the 38.
There's a completion to the tight end, and I think that we're looking at something out of central casting, frankly.
Absolutely. I mean, size, the hands.
Speed, I mean, can flat out run. You put that whole package together, you light up the eyes of an offensive coordinator, don't you?
From the 38, Hurts. It's caught by Sanders. So a big play in this opening drive of overtime. Now looking at a third and three. Throwing is Hurts. And once again, this is Sanders. And he's going to be taken down at about the 33.
They've been moving the ball well, but this drive was in danger of stalling out. Fortunately, this is a nice throw here, and they're able to pick up a new set of downs.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Hurts sets up to throw it. He's got Dallas Goedert, his tight end, over the middle. And he's going to be taken down at the 28-yard line. From the 28, it's second and five. Throwing from the gun, it's Hurts. And he's going to be taken down here. A sack back at the 32. Give that sack to Harrison Phillips, the big man. That time, finally, a measure of revenge as they get him down behind the line.
It almost felt like relief, didn't it? Because with the success he's had throughout this game, you'd almost expect him to get free and pick up 10 to 15 every time he takes off. Not in that case. That has to feel good for the defense.
So after that sack, Hurts and the Eagles, tough spot here, third and long. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Looking right side, and that's complete to Watkins. And his bid for the first down coming up short as he's tackled at the 25. They'll wind up getting seven on the play, and that's going to bring up a fourth down.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks. Don't let them get there. And they've rallied and made the tackle.
Going for it with Sanders. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. A gigantic call there in overtime, but it pays off with a first down. Well-executed fourth down conversion.
Yeah, I know this will surprise you, but I've actually done a little bit of reading lately, and all the analytics say that you should go for it more on fourth down. I think someone has referred back to their analytics coach. Maybe he's got a pipeline into the booth because that was a really good play call.
They'll run with Sanders. No dice this go around. He's hit behind the line and taken down. It was Danielle Hunter to make the play in the backfield.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
They'll try again on second and goal after going backwards to the 12. They'll go again with Sanders. And able to get him inside the five here, just inside the five to about the four.
78 yards rushing for him now to this point.
They've had some success here in overtime with this opening drive running the football right back to that well.
And why not? When you have that kind of success, make them stop you. And until they do, keep going back to that well you just spoke about. I think there's more water there available to them.
They'll look to throw on third and goal. And he is in for the score. And it is absolute stunned silence here as they win it on the road in overtime. As the fans exit back out through the turnstiles, not happy looks on their faces. Feel like they probably let this one slip away at home in overtime.
I would agree with that, and their unhappiness hurts the guys at the concession stands on the way out, right? Not stopping to buy something for the kids. They just want to get home. But what a dramatic way to finish this bad boy off. I mean, this game was dramatic all the way through. That's why we got to overtime. And then to go ahead and finish it this way, the fans screaming out unhappy, but the team that came in here and won this one on the road, they sprinted to their locker room.
And speaking of buying things, dinner on you tonight, Davis.
I kind of figured that was coming.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away.
Fields it right around the goal line. And he'll go down as this drive will start at the 25-yard line.
And now out comes Minnesota.
Let's go, man. Do your thing. It's right now.
Cousins and the Vikings with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. They'll try and start this drive in the air.
That's complete. It's Cook.
Nifty move. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That play going for 16 yards to start the drive. First down. Working out of the gun, Cousins lets it fly for Thielen. And this one is incomplete. Keeping the aggression going on defense in overtime here, a first down blitz.
You know you can get burned on it big time if they pick it up. But in this situation, they brought the blitz, put some pressure on the QB, and he wasn't able to complete a pass downfield.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Cousins. It's caught on the right side at Smith. And he has another first down as they'll get the ball down to the Eagles 43. Now a timeout called for by the offense. They'll be left with just one remaining here at OT. So from Philadelphia territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 43. Cousins. He'll dump this off to Cook. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down. Now a timeout called for by the offense. It'll be their second and final timeout, remember, here in overtime. We'll be back. Only needing 2 yards on second down. Cousins again. It's caught, Smith. And he'll be taken down here just shy of the 30. It'll be a pickup of 4, good enough to earn him yet another first down.
what we got. Show them what you got.
They go play action. Cousins. He's going to... And now look at this. Big gain, but a fumble. And it's picked up by the Eagles. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And my, how the tables have turned. They had a chance inside the red zone. Punch that thing in and end it. Now we're going the other way.
And it's real easy to just look at them and say, boy, what an error, what a mistake you made. But how about the defense coming up huge?
There.
Let's give them a little bit of credit, keeping their team in the game, because if they score a touchdown there, it's game over.
So it's the Eagles who get the win here. And the guy who really led the way was their quarterback, CD, and that's Jalen Hurts.
Yeah, what struck me was how composed he was in the pocket. The numbers weren't spectacular. He had two touchdown passes, that's it. But he led his guys on some important drives when they needed it most, and they're going to come away with the victory.